Welcome students. Today we are going to discuss code vita problems which was asked in contest 5. The first problem is on a cube. I read the problem statement. A solid cube of 10 cm by 10 cm by 10 cm rests on the ground. It has a beetle on it and some sweet honey spots at various locations on the surface of the cube. The beetle starts at a point on the surface of the cube and goes on the honey spot in order along the surface of the cube. Please understand, the beetle travels along the surface of the cube. If it goes from a point to another point on the same face, say x to y, it goes in an arc of a circle that subtends to an angle of 60 degrees at the center of a circle. If it goes from one point to another on a different face, it goes by the shortest path on the surface of the cube, except that it never travels along the bottom of the cube. These two constraints are important. It goes from a point to another point on the same face, say x to y. In this situation, z axis will not change. At that time, the distance may be calculated by using different formula. Here, if it goes from one point to another point in a different face, it goes by the shortest path on the surface of the cube, except that it never travels along the bottom. Which is used to identify the minimum. We need to identify shortest path on the surface of the globe. Okay. For second concern, we need to apply that. The beetle is a student of Cartesian geometry and knows the coordinates x, y, z of all the points it needs to go to. The origin of the coordinates is uses is one corner of the cube on the ground and z-axis points of. Hence, the bottom surface on which it does not crawl is z equal to 0 and the top surface z equal to 10. The beetle keeps track of all the distance traveled and rounds the distance traveled on two decimal places once it reaches the next spot, so that the final distance is sum of the rounded distances from the spot to spot. The input format will be, the first line gives an integer n, the total number of points including the starting point the beetle visits. The second line is a set of 3n comma separator negative non-negative numbers with up to 2 decimal places each. These are to be interpreted as group of 3 as the x comma y comma z coordinates of the points the beetle needs to visit in the given order. Output format: one line with a number giving the total distance traveled by the beetle accurate to two decimal places. Even if the distance traveled is an integer, the output should have two decimal places. Constraints: none of the points beetle visit on the bottom face, z equal to 0, or any of the edge of the cube, the lines where two faces meet. This is the constraint. None of the points beetle visits is on the bottom of the face. Does not visit bottom of the face or any of the edges of the cube. Okay, the lines where two faces meet. The n values range from 2 to 10. Consensus is also important. Does not go to bottom face. Here they are given an input as 3. 3 means they will give 3 Cartesian coordinates values which are separated by using comma. 1, 1, 10. This is corresponds to 1 point. 2, 1, 10. This corresponds to 1 point. 0, 5, 9. This corresponds to 1 point. The output will be 6.05. So I will tell how to calculate this one. Constraints are, if it goes from a point to another point on the same face, that is x to y. In this situation, z axis will not change. It goes on an arc of a circle. Okay, that substance with the angle of 60 degree. They have mentioned this. Okay, they have mentioned this situation, first condition. Okay. So if it goes from a point to another point in the same phase, it goes on an arc of a circle. The substance has an angle of 60 degree at the center of the circle. Okay. If you find the distance between x and there is values, two coordinate values, x and y, just have a value and take that value, that is considered as a radius between radius the corresponds to a circle. By using that, we can find the, by using the radius, we can find the arc length. So for example, consider we have in the center of a circle and the distance between two points will be the x1, y1 and x2, y2. By using that, we can find the arc length. Okay, it forms some angle, no? That angle is 60 degree. By using the angle and the radius, we can find the arc length. 2 phi r into theta divided by 360. Okay. In this situation, for example, there are 3 points visited by the beetle, n equal to 3. The beetle starts on the top of the face of the cube, n z equal to 10, at point 1, 1, 10, and goes to another point on the same face. Same face means we need to find the distance as well as we need to find the arc length, is given in the constraint itself. Okay, here the z axis values are same, no? Z axis value is same means it is in the top of the face, same face only. Okay, so we need to find the distance between two data point is 1. Okay, though the straight line distance is 1 because it is travels on the surface of the cube, so difference between the this point and this point, absolute difference, okay, which is 1, and it also travels on the arc of the circle subtending to the angle of 60 degree at the center of the circle. Okay, so and hence it travels 2 phi divided by r, that is 2 phi into the distance between the data points, that is a radius, 2 phi r divided by 6 or 1.05. Okay, so this is to be the distance between these two data points if the phase is same. Okay, it then travels from 2, 1, 10 on the phase 10 to 0, 1, 9. Okay, there is another data point here. The phase changed means no need to use the arc length. Okay, we can find the shortest distance between the two data points. Here we have 2, 1, 10 and 0, 1, 9 on the face x 0 along the surface of the cube. This is a distance of 3. So the distance can be calculated as it is something like, because it is a straight line distance only. We don't use Euclidean distance here. Okay. For finding the surface path, because the beetle travels on the surface of the cube. Okay, don't use Pythagorean theorem at all. Okay, the distance between two data points is 2, because 2 minus 0, 2, then 10 minus 1, 1, total distance is 3. So 1.05 plus 3, 4.05. So output is 4.05. For another input, different kind of input, consider n equal to 3, the beetle start on the top of the face of the cube, z equal to 10 at 1, 1, 10, and goes another point at the same phase, 2, 1, 10. So the phase is same, no? So the straight, you have to identify the straight line distance between the two data points, it is 2 minus 1, 1. Okay, and we need to find the arc length, which is summed up, finally you will get 1.05. Okay, when you apply the formula 2 phi r into theta 360, you will get 0.05. So if it is summed up, you will get 1.05. It then travels from 2, 1, 10 to 0.5, 9 on the face x equal 0 along the surface of the cube. Okay, because x equal 0, no? On the face x equal 0 along the surface of the cube. Means the distance will be the shortest distance on the surface of the cube between this one, 5. Because here the distance between 1 and 5 is 4. And when it goes towards the x axis, means the distance is 6. When it goes towards z axis, means the distance is 5. So we need to find the shortest distance between this point, which is 5. Finally, you will when you accumulate 5 plus 1.05, you will get 6.05. Okay, this can be implemented by using C program language. Here I define a function. This is a header file, and define a function to find the absolute value of particular variable. If x here I define function x less than 0, means just avoid the negation. Okay, it is converted into plus value. Else it just return the value which is passed in the argument itself, and find this one is finding the minimum element among two floating point value. Just check the condition if x less than y, means just return x, otherwise return y. This is used for implementing this one. First I create a data structure for coordinate, Cartesian coordinate, which has the three data members x axis, y axis, z axis. For getting the set of points, data points, we have declared an array, okay, structure array. For getting the number of data points, use n. And for storing the Cartesian coordinates, the as a floating point variable, I have created a floating point array, and read the data as a string, line of text, because the input is in the form of comma value followed by comma, no? So we need to take as a line of text and tokenize it. Here separator is comma. Okay, until the end of string reads, you have to tokenize it. Whenever you read the data, which is by default, which is considered a string, which is to be converted into floating point value by using ATOLL. Okay, you should convert the string to integer, long values, which is converted into floating point value. Okay, it is stored in the VFK. It is stored in the quotient components, used the VFK. Then after that, I store these data values into coordinate, Cartesian coordinate structure. Okay. Here I used 3*i, y means for first data points it comes 0, 1, 2, for second data points it comes as 3, 4, 5. Okay. For getting the data from the B array, I use this formula. Okay, because I'm taking three values from the array and storing into the Cartesian coordinate. Okay. So I have stored into the Cartesian coordinate array. Now I check each and every data point to find the distance between the beetle travel, how long it is traveled between the by using the Cartesian coordinate. First I check whether the one data point is traveled. Compare one data point with another data point and check whether it is travel on the same face, that is between x and y. For the purpose, I just check first data point and the second data point's z axis value. If it is equal, means it traveled on the same face. If it is travel on the same face, means just to check first data point and second data point, not x value is not equal to x, not equal. Not equal mean just to find the absolute difference and apply the absolute difference value. Okay, take that value. This is the distance, straight line distance traveled by the beetle plus that is arc length. This arc length is calculated by 5/60 into formula is already given. Okay. Next, these values are stored in the sum variable. Next, if y, first coordinate y value is not equal to second coordinate y value, means there is a distance. So if it is different distance, means just find the absolute difference and store the data, straight line distance plus angle, arc length. You have to find the arc length. Okay. After that, you need to check if it is traveled in the different phase. Okay. Means it goes to L spot. In L spot, just to check first coordinate value, y value is equal to second coordinate y value. Equal means just find the absolute difference between the first coordinate x value and second coordinate x value and first coordinate z value and store into sum. Okay. Else, which is different, y axis value is different. So find the absolute difference between the y minus the first coordinate y value minus second coordinate y value plus minimum of first coordinate x value. Absolute minimum of absolute difference of first coordinate x value minus second coordinate x value, comma absolute value of first coordinate z value minus second coordinate z value. Okay. So this is used to find the shortest distance between the data points. Okay. Finally, print the sum. This is a little difficult problem. Okay. In which you don't find any reference or any keys or answers in the internet. Okay. Next problem is sorting the boxes. This is also a difficult problem. I read the problem statement. Problem title is sorting the boxes. The parcel section of the head post office is in a mess. The parcels that need to be loaded to the vans have been lined up in a row in an arbitrary order of weights. The head postmaster wants them to be sorted in an increasing order of the weights of the parcels, with one exception. He wants the heaviest parcel kept nearest to the surface. Okay. So heaviest, we need to sort the data in ascending order, but only one concern is the heaviest box should be nearest to his office. You and your friend try to sort these boxes and decide to sort them by interchanging the two boxes. At the time, only two boxes are exchanged. Such an interchange needs effort equal to the product of the two boxes. The objective is to reposition the boxes as required with the minimum effort. Okay, here, input format is the first line consists of the two separate positive integers, giving the number of boxes n and the position of the head of the master office k. Okay, so the greatest element is available in the kth position, where the heaviest box must be. The second line consists of the n space separator positive integers and giving the weight of the boxes. You may assume that no two weights are equal. Okay. In output format, the output is one line giving the total effort taken to get the boxes in sorted order and the heaviest in position k. Okay. We are arranging the data in ascending order only, but the thing is, heaviest box should be in the kth position. The constraints are n less than or equal to 50 and weights and weights less than or equal to 1000. Here I giving the size of an array and the kth position of a heaviest box. Okay. We are giving the data in order to 20, 50, 30, 80, 70. Now the output will be, the minimum effort will be 3600. Okay. For other, if I exchange two values, means the cost will be 1000, because 20 into 50, okay, absolutely 1000. Here explanation for this example, there are 5 boxes, n equal to 5, and the heaviest box must be in the position k equal to 5. If you look at the final order, sorted order, it should be 20, 80, 30, 50, 70. Actually 70 is, after ascending order, 70 should be available in the last position. But here, constraint is the heaviest box should be available in the second position. That is, in place of 50, the output should be 20, 80, because heaviest box available in the second position. 80, 30, 50, and 70. Okay. accept 80, we have 30, 50, 70 is offered. Before that, we have a smallest element. If you look at this, we notice that only the 50 and 80% need to be accepted. 50 and 80. Okay, here 50 and 80. Before we have this value and this value should be exchanged. When you exchange this, what is the cost? 4000. Okay. Rather than exchanging these two values to get more cost, we can use smallest element, okay, as an intermediary to reduce the cost. Okay, so I will tell how it is possible. Okay. As this take effort of the product of this, the effort is 3600. Further, the reduction can be obtained. Okay. Directly, if you exchange means the cost is 4000. Reduction can be applied by taking the smallest package as an intermediary. For example, if we exchange 20 with 50, the effort is 1000. Then 20 with 80, the effort is 1600. And back with 50, that is 20 with 50, you will get 1000. Totally, the cost of this is 600. No? If you stay straight away, you are exchanging 50 with 80, means cost is 4000. If you use this 20 as smallest element as intermediary, means the cost will be very, very less. So by using this key, we can solve this problem. Okay. Here also I use compare function, which is discussed previously. Okay, how to use a compare function in sorting the elements in ascending order. Here I get in n and k by using Karam statement. The F gives three arrays. Okay, first array is meant for getting the array element. Second array, third array, the temporary array for handling the position of the data. Okay, after sorting, what is the position that should be maintained in the array? Okay. User gives k equal to 2 means it will be decremented by 1, because array is always starting from 0 only. No, so second position means in array it is a first position. Okay, because array is starting from 0. Okay, this is the answer. Initially it was 0, and I maintain 2 variable to keep the index of the values after exchanging. Okay, here maintain the maximum minimum value which is should be kept as maximum initially. While getting the input itself, I can find the position of AFI and storing the AFI values to BFI and CFI, and finding the minimum element in the list itself, and along with that the index, because by using the minimum index only, there is a smallest element only, we are exchanging the data of the minimum effort. Okay, so I am in a position to keep track of the index of the minimum value, because I use minimum value as an intermediary. Okay, as well as the minimum mn value is used to get the value of the smallest element. Just sort b array and c array in ascending order. Initially, B array and C array has array element which is inputted in the AFI only, which is sorted in ascending order. Okay, and just exchange the last value with the last value. Okay, just take starting from n minus 1. After sorting last greatest element is available in the last position, no, that will push it into second position. Okay. That is why I use BFI equal BFI minus 1. Once it's positioned, just set PFK equal to CFN minus 1. Okay. After shifting, just set the greatest element in the list to the kth position. Okay. After that, just store the index of the BFI. Okay. The pivot position of F variable. Okay. Here starting from the last position, okay, and ending with the first position. Okay. I just find the cost. Okay. I just find the current value of the variable with the I take one variable, one value in the array, it is a current value, okay, position of f, and multiplied with the c of I value, okay, which is retrieved from the c array, and that is stored in the r cast. And in f cast, I just multiplying the current value with the shortest, smallest element, I can find the cost. Comparing R cost with F cost, if it is less than means just exchange, reposition it. Okay, repositioning A variable with the C variable. Okay, the C variable only contains sorted data in sorted order. Okay, then it is not less than means just exchange the A variable with the minimum variable. Okay, I will show the demo how to implement it. As I show the Cartesian coordinate problem. On the cube problem. Just to give value 3, giving the data and the order. First coordinate, second coordinate values. Output will be 6.0. We need to round up to decimal point. By using printf statement, find 2f. We all can use find 2f. Answer. For the second problem, input will be value 20 followed by 50 followed by 30 followed by 80 followed by 70. So you have printed the data. So B array, C array has the element sorted order. After exchanging the last value with the last value, just positioning the repositioning the data. I take 80 in the temporary array and 30 and 50, 70 to right position. When you move right position, 80 will be becoming it will come to second position. So this B array contains this value only. Okay, so I maintain the index of the B array. So after that, I maintain the index of this after sorting. What is the index of each and every element? For example, here 30 is available in the second position. No, for example, in array we have 30. This 30 value is available in the second position. No, so this 30 value available in second position, that is 0, 1, 2, second position before sorting, that is maintained here. And 50 is available in the first position, 1th position, that is maintained here. Okay, so position of the array before sorting, after sorting, maintained by using the POSF and POS variable. That's all. After exchanging, the position may be changed. Here, I get two cost, R cost and F cost. R cost is 4000, R cost may be 4000, F cost may be 2600. We need to find the smallest, we need to take smallest among this. So, for first iteration, the smallest is 2600. The second iteration, the smallest is 1000. So 2600 plus 1000 equal to 3000. Every time we need to find the cost without using smallest element in the list. We need to calculate the cost and store into R cost. Okay, by using smallest element in the list, what is the cost, what is the effort needed, that you have to check. That is stored in the F cost. Just compare R cost with the F cost. If R cost is less, means you can consider that cost value with the answer value. Otherwise, you can store it into, you can store F cost value to the add F cost value to the answer variable. Finally, you will get 3000. Okay. So these two problems were very difficult. Okay, we don't find any reference from the internet. Okay. We will see in the next session. Thank you.